Joining us now is Dr. Robert Murphy. He's a professor of infectious diseases at Northwestern University Feinberg School of Medicine. Thanks for joining us, doctor.
Hey, good morning.
So we just read the story about AstraZeneca and whether that will get approved. We've talked about this a lot the past couple of weeks. I imagine there may be some people who are squeamish about getting it. What are your thoughts on it?
Well, I think this finally answers the question. Here you have a nice 32,000 person trial where everything went okay. They didn't screw up the dose or the dose interval or anything like that. Most of the patients here in the United States, we trust the data here. We did it and it looks fine. I think we just got to get over this. The problem is, Larry, when you vaccinate millions of people, which is what's happening, you see all sorts of medical problems because we just see medical problems. And look at the age of the people getting it and whatever. So we just have to stop that and just let this thing get out there because we need more vaccine.
We're seeing some video from some spring break hotspots, Florida being the main one that I'm thinking of. Do you think that we will see another surge or a smaller surge potentially?
Lauren, it's a big debate right now. You've got people on one side saying we're definitely going to have another wave. And then you have others, like the former FDA director, Scott Gottlieb, thinks that it's just going to be more of a plateau or a little wave because so many people are vaccinated. In other words, the impact of the vaccination is kind of holding things back, and maybe we'll pull this wave back, similar to what's happening in the United Kingdom right now. So in the UK, for those of you who don't know, it is not spiking there like it is over continental Europe. And it's because the United Kingdom has vaccinated more people than anybody in Europe. Hmm. So you know, that's good. But spring break, it's very dangerous down in Florida because they have most of the Brazilian P1 variant. And if that comes up here, kind of a game changer, unfortunately, on the bad side.
Tell us about a possible oral COVID vaccine.
Very interesting, Larry. You know, we're not used to really oral vaccines a lot, but an Israeli company has been working on orally administered drugs that are normally given by injection, such as insulin. They've got the technology. They work with the Indians to manufacture this stuff. And they showed in animals that this oral vaccine actually, the animals produce an antibody. So the phase one study in humans is starting pretty soon. We should have results from that in 3 months. Very promising because it works against three of the different COVID proteins, not just the spike protein. So if this works, total game changer, but we got a long way to go.
I thought this was interesting that a recent analysis found that states that opened up the vaccine to larger groups of people first, like Florida and South Carolina, are now trailing behind states that took a more methodical approach. Are you surprised by that?
Lauren, this is a great comment and a great story here because it's complicated doing this. You can't vaccinate millions and millions of people, hundreds of millions of people here in the United States. You can't do it just by, hey, come get your vaccine. Any first come, you know, first gets it, whatever. Florida, Missouri, what was the other state that did that? There were three of them. South Carolina. They couldn't handle it. They couldn't handle the rush. And so that clogged everything up. People made appointments and they had to cancel them and everything. And as a result of that, they vaccinated fewer people than practically every other state.
All right, let's get to viewer questions. My husband and I have had both doses of the vaccine, and we didn't have any reactions to either one except a sore arm with the second dose. Just wondering if they work since we were expecting more of a reaction.
Don't worry about not getting a bad reaction to a vaccine. Actually, about half the people have almost no reaction. So don't worry about it. It does not correlate with the protective nature of the vaccine.
Is it safe to receive a second Pfizer vaccine after experiencing severe upper body hives that have persisted over 3 weeks?
No. This is a severe reaction, and this person should not take the next one. Who knows what will happen the next time? So a good alternative would be the Johnson & Johnson vaccine for this person. They should seek that out.
All right, next question. I heard because there was not a lot of flu this year due to everyone wearing a mask, they are having trouble developing a flu vaccine for the fall. Is this true?
No, I don't think so. I think, you know, most of the flu vaccine, they determine the vaccine based on what's happening in Asia. So I don't think that's going to be a problem.
Dr. Murphy,
but I don't think flu is going to be a problem either. So but I think we should still take our vaccine.
Dr. Murphy, thanks for joining us this morning. Good to see you.
Okay.
Thank you, doctor.
If you have a question for Dr. Murphy, head to our Morning News Facebook page and post it there. We'll talk to